Welcome back to the program. It's Capital Market here on Channels Television. Well, we've been discussing issues, developments, innovations, and the Nigerian Capital Market Depository, that's the CSC, as popularly known as the Central Securities Clearing System. And of course, we have with us Folagbade Adeyemi, who's the head of clearing and settlement operations at this particular platform.
Well, before we went on break, we spoke a bit about the upgrade that you have from Thomas Murray, yes. And of course, all of the recertification around your international security standards and all of that. But then let's look at some core operations of the your company, actually, of the CSCS, and that's the one of the key points you're trying to do around unclaimed dividends, which is estimated around at about 100 billion naira right now. Yeah. What are the latest strategies you're leveraging to reduce that? Because it is not a responsibility for companies or the stock exchange and, of course, the SEC alone. Mm-hmm. It's basically a kind of a shared responsibility.
Yes. Just like you said, being a shared responsibility, though dividend payments largely has been done by registrars, what we do is that we work with the SEC and the registrar community to craft out strategies to boost awareness about unclaimed dividends. Because largely the main challenge is the fact that investors don't actually know what is unclaimed. Then in terms of what CSCS actually does, what we do is we ensure that investors' signatures are properly captured and transferred to the registrars. So my own advice, bit of advice to any individual investor is that to actually just get empowered by knowing what is out there, seek information as much as possible by approaching the different investor, the different registrars, and then CSCS can also play its part by providing the additional support.
So you also got this whole transmission of dead investors' portfolio, all of shares, and of course other securities that belong to a deceased.
Yeah.
What's the latest about that? Because it is something that the a lot of the shareholder activists are really, really in support of.
Yes, and that is and actively and rightly so. There needs to be a lot more activity around late investors' securities because that is a part of their income that they need to actualize for the future generation. And in terms of what CSCS can do and what anybody else out there can do is, like I said, to actively engage the investment community, particularly the registrars, and also the CSCS themselves. We have a new contact center that is more customer-centric, that allows you to even just walk in and make inquiries about investments and securities.
Does it come with a phone call number?
There is a phone number which we will which I'll try to share before the end of the show.
Okay.
And that, like I said, you can have a call center call in. It's just as simple like you could call any other call center for a financial institution, and people will be you'll be attended to. I mean, our website also has a chat messenger facility, which you can make inquiries on that platform that and have feedback from on simple things like this.
Okay, so you're not going to be doing this whole transmission of dead investors reforms thing alone.
No,
how much of other regulatory sides of things we will be seeing going forward?
So, as a matter of fact, the SEC is particularly invested in this part of this part of the market, operational part of the market. It's something that, if just thinking about it, if we could unlock that liquidity, unlock those shares from late investors, it can easily turn to turnover in the market and improve capitalization. You can imagine how the capital markets community is very invested in it. The SEC is looking at potentially creating a situation whereby those fees, which has made people a little worrisome, or reduced, and also having active engagements with probate offices to ensure that it's less troublesome for individual investors to carry out that transmission process. So definitely high-level discussions are being had in the community to ensure that it's more seamless going forward.
But will next of kins and beneficiaries of all of this disease still be able to get all of those accumulated dividends
all
of that if things become reformed eventually?
Oh, yes, definitely. Nothing is actively lost when it comes to dividends or your investments. It may just be held in lieu of you coming to actually claim it, but you can never actually lose it.
But what exactly happens now to all of those investments?
So in terms of those investments now, what it happens is it really just accumulates. But in terms of, that's on the dividend side. On the share side, on the security side, it still waits there. And assuming there's any other corporate action that happens, you will be able to claim it once you come and stand and claim your right.
What about a case whereby the company has been delisted? What happens to the assets of that particular deceased?
That's a very good question. And even with a company being delisted, it does not mean that a company does not exist. Okay. So it just means that it's not tradable on the Nigerian Stock Exchange, which means you can still claim your assets, which means you can still be entitled to corporate actions going forward. If the company pays a dividend, you still will be able to claim your dividend. It might be a little harder for you to liquidate your assets because it's no longer on the secondary market, but you can you are still an investor, you are still a shareholder and a part owner of that company.
So all you then need to do, or basically what role should I say, that will requirements like letters of administration and co will be playing out? Or will it be phased out?
No, for now it won't be phased out. In terms of the turnaround time, in terms of implementing these things, may be a little faster.
Okay.
But definitely securing your assets will be a lot easier and more efficient. I think identifying those securities is where we as a CSCS, as a CSD, can actually play a positive role. Because if you can walk to the CSCS with the necessary documentation, you will actually have access to the statement. Mm. And then turning it over will be having a discussion with your stockbroker.
Okay, so let's go back a bit to your reforms. You have a rebranding program. You also have some new other new initiatives like document management, legal identity identification, and
So in terms of the rebranding, over the past two years, the CSCS has actually gone through a process of transformation. And what it means is that not only are we transforming ourselves operationally, but in terms of our mindset, our culture, the entire essence, ethos of the CSCS in itself is changing, and which speaks to the fact that we are going to be carrying out a rebranding exercise to actively reflect this change that is happening in the CSCS itself. I mean, just listening to the initiatives alone, it tells you that we are definitely more customer-focused because we now have the customer at the center of all the activities we're doing. So that speaks definitely to the fact that rebranding is going to happen, and we're very positive that's going to happen over the
What's
next couple
really
of months.
What's going to really happen? Is it a change of name or just a change of logo?
No, it's a change of essence. It's a change of operations, how CSCS is even perceived in the market space. So top of mind awareness will definitely change, and change of logo, possibly in the future, yes.
Okay, so you're tradable on the NASD OTC, that's your listed securities. Any plans to get on the Nigerian Stock Exchange? I keep wondering how that is going to happen.
It can happen. There's nothing stopping it from happening. It's just a matter of how we choose to strategically position ourselves in the future. Good thing is, right now, investors can actively trade on the NASD.
But what's the outlook for 2019? Because investors, you have huge number of investors that are really, really keeping their eyes on CSCS.
Yes.
When are you paying out dividends?
I believe we're going to have our AGM coming up very soon. It's going to be
For
the year 2018.
Of course, you made some good billions in 2018.
We make some good dividends. I must say that I think we're paying about 70 kobo in terms of the proposed 70 kobo.
Possibly.
Yes, and I think that on the website, we actually have our annual reports out there on the website for potential investors to look at. And truth is, the CSCS is positioning itself to be definitely a key entity to watch out for in the future. And that speaks to the positive horizons for anyone who's interested in investing in the CSCS.
So it looks like the dematerialization that you were able to achieve two years ago or thereabouts, actually paved way for a whole lot of these reforms in the technology space, right?
Definitely, the dematerialization in itself positively created a platform for us to even move in terms of ratings for our CSCS platform.
Yeah.
So I think with that alone, it will encourage investors to actually look into what they had. And also that creates a spillover effect into turnover. Mm-hmm. Because the more people are aware of securities they have, the more turnover and trading happens.
But in just one word, are you confident that your three-year roadmap will be well accomplished in 2020? Because that's when the expiration
I'm confident. I'm confident we'll have some positive outcomes of that. Very confident.
I appreciate your time. Folagbode Adeyemi, Head of Clearing and Settlement Operations at the CSCS.
Thank you
for coming.
Thank you very much.
Well, on that note, we'll bring the show to a close. That's it for this program this weekend. I appreciate your time on it. I'm Temple Ashaju. I'll see you again next time. Bye.